Hey everyone, welcome to PowPow Island DIY TV. I'm your host, Lucky, and this is episode 5, a little bit more about rivers and how to decorate around them. Okay, let's get right to it. So, does anyone notice anything different? Now, if you're new here, of course, you might not, but for those of you that have been watching this series, I moved this one space forward. So I gave myself a 3-deep river now in the front of my house. So why did I do that? Well, we need to take a quick run for me to show you this. And yes, you'll see a little bit as we go, but I'll leave the suspense for all that. So I'll link down below in the description about the video with the holes in the ground for those of you that, again, are new here. But for those that remember this, a fish will only spawn when there is a river width that is 3 wide. Now, length, as you can see, I needed 3 as well here. It won't spawn in anything that's smaller than 3 by 3. So these fish are coming by themselves, no problem. Now, these little skater guys that you saw, there's a little character skating around. Any of the pond characters, somehow I've seen them close to this area, but I made this one here. And why? Because I want to show you. If we take fish bait and scatter it, it won't let me. It's telling me clearly it can only be scattered in water that has fish in it. Now, we don't have fish in there, and even when there was no fish in here, let's just startle this little character by doing something. If I run past, there we go, okay. So, if I now stand here and sprinkle food, it lets me, and voila, a little fish appears. So this is the same premise with rivers. And why I want to talk to you is that in our last video, episode 4, all about rivers, this was pretty much, well, the picture that I ended up with would have been around here. And the angle of the waterway was what was fascinating. I basically said it looks really nice with these points. So after I left, finished the video, I thought, okay, I don't like the straightaway. Remember, there was nothing but a huge straightaway here? So this is one of the reasons I've changed this, not only for it to look much more natural, but fish will not spawn anywhere in this area if it's only 2 wide. And I really wanted some fish activity on this side. So this is 2 pieces of land were removed, and then the end 2 pieces were angled. And I wanted to make a quick demo of that because I think this becomes something interesting to see. So let's quickly put our hat on. I've opted to be in my lovely spring outfit. It was something my daughter brought over to my island yesterday, and it was a nice spring day until I decided to make a video and the heavens opened up. So we'll just have a island rainfall here. So let's get right to our water tool, which we have right here, and let's build this back out. Okay, and then the same with on this side here. Oopsie-daisy. Let's just fill it all in. So when I left you in video episode 4 of this DIY river work, this was what it looked like. It was a straightaway. And I originally put 3 of these bamboo benches. I thought, okay, call it a day. I thought, no, that's not going to work for me. So I dove right in and I took one piece away and I took the next piece right beside it, which is, oopsie-daisy. See, now that's interesting. I don't want to go that far over. See, now I've got 3 spaces. That's too much. I don't want that. So I'm going to fill in this one here. Okay. So I only want this 2 wide. And I'm going to angle this corner here because that's what happens now. We're seeing everything in the cubes, right? So this is attached on 2 sides. I can stand on either one of those sides to do the carving, but that's in the way. So I'm going to stand here. If I hit this now, let's go ahead. See how it angles it? We're going to leave that. We like that. And on this side now, same thing. I'm going to hit this cube. I can stand on either side of it. So let's just stand on this side of the line just to give it a go. And sure enough, it carves it there. So that's how I made that, just to give it a little bit more character. And I'll show you something after I put the bamboo stool down, because we do need seating. Again, all of that's DIY things. Let's go and put some fish food in here. So it does work, and voila, there you go. You've got a little fish in there. I'm actually going to take off this because I want my pretty hat on. Yeah. Okay, let's just, even though it's rain, we're going to assume it's warm island rain, right? We don't mind it. So there's the fish in this area, and the fish will only stay in this area. It will not swim around the corner, because often fish will swim a ways, because this is too narrow. Now, around the corner, I opted not to change my rivet. I like the way it snakes around. I really like this very nice carved up piece here. But when I got to the other side, I thought, well, I really don't want to lose this width, because it is actually an area where the fish will swim in here. This is the natural line I was given, and as you can see, there's a little fish on that side, but he will only stay over there. He will not swim along here to get to this side, which is really an interesting thing. And no matter how much I stand there and will it, it just doesn't happen. So I'm leaving this natural line that came with the island, and everything on this side of my property is natural to how the island was shaped when I got the game. This now has changed here, and I love this now. As you can see, we have a nice, if you're sitting on the bench and you're relaxing and watching whichever direction, this way or this way, you can see some, it looks nice. It's got a nice feel to it. I noticed that when I was first doing this, gosh, the villagers just went wild. They were all standing around. There was about three fishing here. Hello, move aside, I'm making a video. Now you'll see this is a good visual here. So fish will be here. This fish will not leave. It's going to stay there, which is kind of cool. It will not swim here. Too narrow. This is too narrow, too narrow. Here, fish will happen again. And so let's sprinkle some water in, some food in here. And let's just see if we, yes, I made food for you guys. Fish food. And voila, we have a fish in this area. And that fish now will swim from there to here. However, when we come around the corner, excuse me, I'm losing my voice to how many takes I've made. This now is narrow. This is all too deep, narrow. It's not gonna have fish in there. So I can fish off my bridge. You see, this is that you can fish off of your bridge. And there will be fish on this side. Excuse me. Let me have a drink of my coffee. Excuse me while I fish and drink. There we go. So, you can fish off of your bridge. Great, we're happy to know that. Fish will spawn here because I made that wider. Now, there is the argument here. I could do this. If I wanted a little bit more space in the front of my house, I could move all of this up by one. Same shape, but give it a... But I don't think I will. I kind of like the idea that I can come out the front of my property and throw the fishing rod in and fish. But I do have a question for you before we look at some of the furnishings. What do you think? Is it starting to look like it needs the hedge after all? So if I stand back here and look at my property, I opted to make the sidewalk around, but I feel something's missing here. So I'll let you all decide in the comments below if you think the hedge is the answer. I kind of like it, but popular vote will win. That's right. Okay, so that's it with the hedge, and I kind of like it. I could have put one more piece of hedge down. There's enough walkway to do that, but I'm choosing not to because it gets too close to the little light down here, and that's perfect. So it just makes me feel that the house looks a little bit more finished with it. Now, let's go on this side to the narrow part of our river that we were talking about, and let's put one more time some fish food in here. Yes, I've used a lot of fish food. Scatter the food, and there you go. You'll want to sprinkle it in a body of water with fish in it. So we now know, confirmed, that indeed the river must be at least three wide, three across, in order for it to do this. Now, here's something funny though. When I stood on this side of the lamp here, maybe I just wasn't close enough. You know, I stood here and maybe I was just standing here because this body of water clearly gets fish. And it said the same thing. Now let's just see if I sneak in a little closer. Yes. So this clearly is a big enough body of water, okay? Now, here we go. Furnishings. So as you can see, when we started episode 4, I just had a little spit of land. And I've really given myself a beautiful area to relax and enjoy. So, and you can see the unique shaping around here. So at this stage, what I want to say about furnishings, everything here is pretty much a DIY except for the cute sofa, which I was either I bought in the store or something. Now that Midge is on my island, her entire house is cute furniture in yellow, and it's showing up in the store. So that's an interesting thing. I don't know if there's a correlation with that. However, I did play with this area width-wise, you know, having the sofa here and whatnot. I did originally have the outdoor swing, but it was too tall. I'm very mindful about zooming in. So if I were to zoom in now, I did not want to have tall items. I even tried the tree, and the tree just took away all the visual here. So I didn't want that. I want to see this. I went a lot of trouble. I want to see this and enjoy it. So by having low furnishings and then using the foliage that I have, and because you guys were so great sharing the tip about the weeds, I will be no longer having fire up here now that I've got it down here. I just don't want it there. I will now put some weeds and a little bit of other things up top here. So this area was really, you know, I could have filmed it doing it, but it was really pick up place, move place, pick up place, move place, run back in the house, get something else, make something. That's, I didn't know if you wanted to see all that. I figured I'd show it to you in this stage. It's really pretty. I like it for me. It hits the mark for me. I really find that sitting here, I'm just feeling the love of the natural island feel. It's you know, if I was in a big city and I wanted straightaways for roads, different story. But this is island living, and at that stage, and I play with placement. For example, this cypress here, I originally had it right behind. I had this over. I shaped the underpiece here. I wanted this squared off versus rounded because when it was rounded, the pot didn't look like it was centered properly. So those little visual details bother me, and I'm forever playing with them. So I had the tree initially in front. Didn't like it. It blocked the chair. So, and I really like the touch of the firewood. Lends a little authenticity. And there's room enough. Nothing was squeeze room. Like everything was, like even going through here, I felt that I could, it was flowing nicely along, okay? So that mattered to me. I didn't want, and same with here, I wanted to have total flow coming and going. So that is the rest of the river stuff. And if I stand over here and say my goodbyes, you'll get a really nice visual. So on that note, thanks to everyone who's been tuning into these series. I'm sensing they're being a little helpful, and that makes me really happy, because by doing them, it's actually making me do my own island, which is a win-win. So I hope this one shows you what the end result looks like, and then by having that little visual demo up here just reconfirms what you can do. So when we're really looking at something, we know that this is 1.5 pieces, and if we cut it from this side, it'll only take the corner and leave us a point. If we stand where the pot is or on the other side and cut it from here, it'll take the 1.5. Halves never stay alone, but you can cut it away alone, okay? But it doesn't stay by itself. So those are the little tips and tricks. In the meantime, I'll zoom in and give you all, you know, guess what? Joy and happiness. I'm very joyful and very happy that it looks like this, but I'm more joyful and happy that you've joined me on the journey. So any questions, fire them off down below. If you you know, haven't seen the other episodes, I'll link to them in the description below. And I noticed that I had one of you say that you would like to share my videos. Please do. You probably notice I don't ask you to subscribe and like and all that, because you know whether you're going to do that yourself. I don't need to be telling you to do that. So if you like what you're seeing here, you're probably already subscribed. And I really find that the community we're developing here is amazing. So, joy and happiness, and be safe, be happy, keep smiling, and I'll look forward to seeing you in the next video. Bye-bye.